Hey you guys, Lacey and Steve from Duo Reacts. Thank you so much for stopping by.
And watching Steve and Lacey watch Peaky Blinders.
Yes, season 4, episode 5.
The Duel.
The Duel. Who's the duel gonna be?
It's gonna be Tommy and...
Tommy and Luca?
Yep. Gotta be.
Well, yeah, but I'm... Tommy always has something up his sleeve, I feel
but
like.
But the duel,
so,
though.
Yeah, is it gonna be, like, just them two? Like... I don't know. Anyway, I'm excited to get into this episode. This season has been fantastic so far.
Absolutely.
Every season has been fantastic, but this one has been fantastic.
Yeah, there's never a dull moment in Peaky Blinders.
Right.
There's always something going on and something happening, and Tommy's my man, to be honest.
Agreed.
I mean, we jump in. I've been waiting to watch this, so I want to get into it. I really do.
All right, then.
We'll talk about it afterwards.
We'll talk about it afterwards. Let's do it.
Peaky Blinders.
Got his Tommy gun
mm-hmm.
to kill Tommy.
It's never a good sign.
He may try to surrender. You don't know Tommy very well.
Right. Hey. Kill or be killed here, pretty much.
It's what it sounds like. They ain't playing.
Stay inside.
Yeah, you might want to stay inside. Aw, shit. Oh!
He's kind of in the open, though, but he's got a hell of a weapon to keep him at bay. Look at the frickin' muzzle on that.
It's huge. Oh, all them dishes about to be broke right there. Yo, he was prepared, yeah. All them bullets and only one dude got shot?
The bitch lying to me.
Or Tommy just caught on to what was going on.
Why is he all by himself?
This was planned, remember?
Wow.
Pauly told him where he'd be to save her and Michael, remember? So they knew he was going to be alone here. But Tommy, I think, caught on to the fact.
That toothpick's getting wore out.
He's holding on to that toothpick for dear life. Damn. I have a feeling you're going to die next, buddy. Well, I mean, they're working in his benefit right now. And I was right. He did die next. He's just pissing them off more and more, but, I mean, y'all keep coming. Tommy running through there still trying to at least minimize as many deaths as possible, I guess.
I do give a lot of credit. In that aspect.
Yeah.
I don't like the fact that it's going down there, but...
Well, that's
right
their
now,
fault.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, little boy. Please.
Come in.
Oh, hell no.
Trey. Trey, let me go. Sean.
You let that little boy go right now.
Tommy's going up.
That's what I'm thinking. Oh, I think he caught on to it, too. You're shooting at your own dude there, bro.
Yep.
And now they know you're outside.
One by one.
No.
You are not that dumb, are you?
He is.
The dude was exactly right. These are his streets. He knows them. You don't have him cornered because he knows what he's doing.
The duel.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
I know you own the cops in this dirty fucking town, but you want to be dead before I get here. Come on, me and you, Tommy.
Okay.
Oh, the duel.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
I'll take Tommy in this.
Hunger time's over.
I'm on the entire top.
See, Luke is smart, but he's letting this whole vengeance thing cloud his judgment, I think, because it's not making...
Someone behind him in there.
Oh, the cops. Oh, okay. Dang, they came in force. Oh, he's done. He's pissed.
Staring at him like...
Yeah, I think he's kind of in his own head.
What the fuck happened today, Tom? Did I kill three men? Suppose I took you by surprise, did I? Huh? I knew they were coming.
And how did you know they were coming?
Just after Christmas, I received a letter from Luca Changretta offering to spare my son if I gave up Tommy. And I gave Tommy up.
Because that was the plan that Polly and I agreed on. I knew that Luca would want to pull the trigger himself.
I didn't think Polly would do
so
that.
So he's the set of his bait to bring him in. Yeah,
I had
idiot.
A feeling. I don't know. I really like them two together for some reason.
I do
reason.
Too.
Like, I'm shipping them two, and I hope that... I kind of hope that they end up together. Even though I don't think they will.
What if something happened to her?
I don't drink whiskey or gin anymore, Tom.
Why not?
Because she's pregnant.
Same time as the baby.
What? What?
Yes, it can only be yours. I tell you by the canal when you're fucking somebody else in your head. Except it wasn't her who got pregnant.
No, Saint Lizzie.
Uh-oh. What's he gonna say?
I don't know.
Keeping it.
Who's gonna run me fucking office?
That's what you're gonna find say?
Somebody. Exactly.
I'm not gonna work with a child of mine, I tell you.
Oh, okay.
That's all I had to do?
It's okay, Tom.
All this death, Lizzie. I'm going to have some life, eh? Got three.
No, Tom.
He's still in shock.
One point blank. Point blank, Lizzie.
She's trying to...
And he looks up at me.
She's trying to ease his mind a little bit. He doesn't like killing people.
Get in the house. Every week from the company.
That is not what she wants to hear.
She's trying to ground him with her. He cannot get it out of his head.
It's a bad time. And
but I see what she's...
Yeah, I hope she understands that he literally just killed three people and almost died himself. Like, give him a chance to recover.
Maybe bad timing all the way around.
Bad timing all the way around, maybe.
Little coke, I'm just whiskey.
He's talking to nobody.
Himself?
He's talking to himself, yeah. He's justifying it in his own head why he's getting into this, whatever this is. More drugs. That seems really not smart, Arthur.
Got the coke to make you high, the drink to make you low, you don't know where to go.
He's stuck in a circle. Shit. Yeah, that's exactly what a wife loves to see when her husband comes home.
I'm drunk. I need you to save me.
Before the time comes to plant anything out.
I love her hair, by the way.
Just one minute.
I really do. I really do. I don't know why. Give me this big. I'll tell you what, if I'm riding around, everything's going to be bulletproof at this point.
I don't think things were bulletproof back then, Steve.
I think they had stuff.
And if anyone should come for you, Michael, the Palmers and the Boswells would put up a fair fight. I'll take them.
That hey, guy.
The healer's up there.
Tommy says it won't be long. Then we'll be free.
What do I have a feeling? He's not along for this.
Might learn something. Your royalty up there, Michael.
He's like, oh, great. He really does not want to be doing this.
That's what I'm saying. I just...
Do you know along the way back, Mr. Gold?
I know ways back. Take forever. Good in, Your Majesty.
Wait.
Okay.
Usually this guy, I keep an eye on all the time, but like,
well,
with
because...
her, he seems like...
Maybe he's crushing on Aunt Polly.
I thought you were a busy woman.
Or maybe she's crushing on him.
Snake us.
16 again. And when the police were after your granddad, he used to take us out. We'd gone for days living on what he caught. Oh, do you have a sharp knife?
He's like, of course I do.
It's like putting your head through a window and seeing the whole world.
Interesting no, exchange happening here.
I believe it's you who kept Tommy Shelby alive all these years.
And we've kept each other alive. But I didn't just put my head through that window. I climbed through it. When you put your head out of that window, you can do anything you want. Because there are no rules. Because there are no risks.
The rudest tear I ever seen in my life.
Now give me the knife.
Okay. Now's the best time for you to have a knife.
Now come here.
I freaking knew it.
Well, okay.
I can do whatever I want.
She can do whatever she wants.
Whenever the mood takes me.
Mm.
You are a strong, handsome man. And this is a beautiful place in the world. And it is. This time.
Fucking rat face, man. She's kissing rat face right now.
She is.
Let me make one thing clear, Mr. Gold.
Oh my god, I thought she was going
to
do it.
I just gave my little speech. If any harm comes to Michael, you shall have me as your enemy. And none of your knives can kill me.
You sure about that?
Do you understand?
Oh, I understand. Tutsurink Nimula.
He's... Oh, I understand.
Labrie.
And I'm a little turned on right now. Wow.
That might work with him.
He's down, man. He likes that.
When she feels randy.
She can do whatever she wants, mm-hmm. Okay? She's like, I am a strong woman, and I want that D. And she's gonna have it.
Oh, and here we go
shit.
With part two of crazy.
Got Mr. Solomon's over here. It's always interesting when we see Mr. Solomon's.
I want to hear this conversation.
My little cousin was born blind, but as a result, I now donate and store some money to a charity which gives dogs with eyes to blind Jews. The chairman of the board recommends that... What time is it?
29 minutes past 8.
Right. Well, then I have another minute to go, actually, but you...
I have one more minute, so go ahead.
Oh,
he is not happy.
It's a match, isn't it?
It looks like a match, yeah.
Oh, good job, Rana. Yeah, I know who you are. You're a bit of a failure, aren't you? You come all the way over here. Well, he's not dead, is he? Oh. No. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. Right, hello. How can I help you? I just want to hear you say it out loud. So I'm checked. How ridiculous it is. This has gone out by tens. Here's a gift. It's free. Souvenir if you visit here. Goodbye. Trot on. Down there is Bonnie Street.
It's free.
Damn fucking straight, mate. Otherwise, you wouldn't still be thieving my oxygen, would you?
He's not as easily intimidated.
He is crazy.
He is.
Also, I want some cash. My wife is where I've broken it down here.
What?
He's already broken it down right here.
Because Tommy Shelby, like me, is from an oppressed people. And I need you to put another ton on top of that because his brother is a fucking animal and he will come after me. Well, you are a fucking what, mate?
Oh, Jesus.
Oh!
Tommy Shelby is a very, very good friend of mine.
And I won't sell him out for anything less than $1,000.
All right, well, you will have to add another ton onto your bill for being a cunt, right? All right.
Oh, my God, I love Mr. Solomon so much.
You will circumcise them. Yeah, you will have to circumcise them because the peakies will check, yeah?
Okay.
You're going to circumcise your men for this?
I have a deal.
Yeah, Tommy Shelby was right about you, wasn't he? Yeah, I can have this. I love it.
Oh. I love Mr. Solomon so much.
It's crazy, but he's must-see TV, isn't he?
I don't know that he's crazy. I think he's just very eccentric and very kind of out there. But I think he's very smart, actually.
Crazy smart, okay?
Crazy smart.
But I'm not going to give up on crazy.
Little crazy.
Okay, what are we doing?
I apologize, Miss Shelby.
Your men watched.
They will be reprimanded.
They won't see Saturday.
Naked woman alone making threats against the entire British Army. And here stands you, a woman with her foot in both camps. Potentially very useful.
Useful to who?
Maybe you should ask your brother Thomas.
I don't know. I'm seeing a love connection right here. Am I crazy?
I feel it too. I feel it too. Just because.
Look at the way he's looking at her. I don't know. I'm feeling something there.
No, I agree.
I don't know what it is, but the way the banter back and forth, I like it.
Look.
Yeah.
You know. Even her.
Even her a little bit.
The only cavalryman who got fucking old.
I was strip searched. Two soldiers watched.
Sorry. Ida.
And how is Tommy Shelby, OBE, going to stop a revolution?
Jesse Eames accepted my invitation to dinner.
Oh, Tommy Shelby is going to stop the revolution with his cock.
It's not her the militia you're interested in, it's the people around her.
Why would a man whose medals rust at the bottom of the Salt Lake Canal want to help the British military?
Because I've been offered 3 5-year contracts to supply military vehicles to the British forces in India, Ceylon, Singapore, and Burma. Total value, £2 million.
There'll be no strikes in your factory because Jesse Eden will be in your bed.
So he's planning on using Jesse.
What you were.
I'll put that on your grave, Tom. Tommy Shelby.
Why not?
You gonna help me or not?
Yeah. She will.
Don't I get a choice?
My opinion. That's right.
Oh, okay, nice save there, Tommy.
To the revolution.
Why not?
To the revolution.
We're going to put that on your grave, Tommy Shelby. Why not?
Since I invited you for dinner, I thought I'd cook. I'm approaching the current political crisis.
I don't think she's going to be as easy to seduce as he's going to be used to, I think.
You know the name Suffragettes? Unrest?
Everyone laughed at him at first, but now look, women with serious faces everywhere. When I study a horse race, I study form. So I invited you here for dinner, because you know people. People that want to make this fight real, with guns and ammunition. So before I place a bet on who's going to win, I need to know how strong they are, how serious they are.
Your concern is that if the unthinkable happened, you would find yourself on the wrong side of the barricades.
My natural side of the barricades is the same as yours and as you know. I once believed.
But the war changed you.
Yeah.
Man I love couldn't speak when he got back. Not one word.
I've said very few true words since.
Men who blew the whistles in France are our enemy.
And you're not alone.
I'm not alone.
Well.
I've researched you. We have researched you.
Oh, we?
You've never been a friend to the government. Now imagine you have found out already that no amount of money allows you to pass through the steel sheets that separate class from class.
Yes, then I have learnt.
Not like you would terrify them. I'm betting them what they do.
Will I change the odds, you think?
It's all wound up, Tom. There's some
bad timing, Curly.
I would say.
Bad timing. Walk away. Thank you.
You know, you did a great job.
You did a great job, but walk away.
Are they ready? Margarine, eggs, and bread.
Margarine?
That was all the money we had.
It's pronounced margarine, Tommy.
When I showed you that photo of Greta Drossi, your face changed.
She wanted everything to be different. The whole world.
As do I.
Just more music.
O'Malley, but she was killed.
Come on.
He's trying to get you to fall for him, Jesse. I can't figure out, like, is he playing her or is she playing him? Because it's one or the other.
I think originally he was playing her.
but now she's playing him. I don't know. Ugh. Because I think he might still be playing her. I think they're playing each other.
Billy, did I realize you busted?
Is this a fight?
I think so. Arthur, come on. This is the definitely the fight. Honest Johnny Dodds. Gotta have the word honest in your name. I guess the question is Luca's guy's gonna be the seconds or whatever for Yas Queens.
I do like that.
I like that. Come down, all of them looking like bosses. I love it.
What?
I don't know what he's seeing. He's seeing something, though. Oh, Mr. Solomons.
Of course.
What's up with the cliffhangers tonight?
This is a really good episode. I liked it.
It was a great episode.
The Luca and Solomon talk.
Yeah, it's
the best. My favorite part of the whole.
My favorite part of the entire episode was Mr. Solomon's scene with Luca Changretta, because
that's what I just said.
I know, but I'm agreeing with you.
Okay, you couldn't have just said that?
Steve, I agree with you. Because, yeah, it was amazing that Tom Hardy, anytime he gets on in front of the camera, I feel like it is an amazing performance.
Have I seen him before in some? Because I don't, you keep saying his name, and like I know his work.
He played in one of the Batman movies as Bane.
Okay, well, he had a mask on, so how did I know it was him?
Okay. What else was he in? I don't know. We'll think of that later, but
Yeah.
Anyway, I think that he's an amazing actor, and he plays Mr. Solomons so well, because you never really know what to expect with him. Like, the whole time he's saying how much Tommy is one of his really good friends, and like he really doesn't want to do this, but then at the same time he's like,
okay, doing, so
it would appear
we're on the last episode, this next one
will be the final episode. Do you think
he sets him up? Do you think I'm gonna say no.
I'm gonna say that we're gonna be led to believe that he did set him up, but that ultimately him and Tommy are working together in some way. That,
but Tommy looked awful, like
he was looking around.
He had a face of concern.
Like, I saw that. I did see that.
Which worries me a lot, because he looks like
somebody that he's seen, like something in particular.
I don't know what he
rubbed
saw.
Him the wrong way. Now, I think it might have been a person, but what person would be there that would rub him the wrong way like that? Because I don't know that Luca would just be that brazen to just...
Well, Solomon was supposed to be there anyway.
Yeah, he was supposed to be there anyway, but we're left to wonder, is he giving Tommy up? Is he...
I don't think so, but going his through with look the plan? Tells another story. His look tells another story. I mean, I'm excited to watch the next one, obviously. This is such a good, like, series. I enjoy it.
This was an amazing episode.
Sometimes, you know, I'll be really honest. When I sit here quiet,
it's because
I'm taking it in.
I know.
I'm enjoying the actual show. And it's, you know,
sometimes
I find myself just immersed in the characters. Like, you know, even Polly when she talks. And when she was at the, you know, and like everything they do, they just pull you in.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah.
No, I agree.
It's hard to, you know, it's easier to speak about afterwards, obviously. But all the acting in this is so good. And they play their parts really well. And, I mean, Tommy lives it. That's what I'm saying, is when he does this show, you know how you can tell people are just acting or whatnot?
Yeah.
He takes it to a whole new level. Like, Even how he smokes a cigarette or his...
He's embodied this character.
That's what I'm trying to get.
In every way, shape, and form. Like, his walk, his style, the way he talks, the way his facial expressions. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, I get what you're saying. And just like what Blair just said, Tom, he is Tommy Shelby. Like, nobody else could play Tommy Shelby, like, the way he can.
It's incredible to me. Because when I watch him, his acting is, you know, like I always said, I always liked, you know, Leonardo
DiCaprio.
Yeah. I love his acting. But God, this guy, when, you know, even, and he does that. He does that as well. And I love when a character takes over and owns that shit. And what he does is he owns this character.
He owns it, yeah.
So, I mean, big time.
Yeah.
Love it. And the rest of them as well. You know,
I think
Holly,
they all do an amazing
Arthur,
job.
Every one of them. And even Luca, you know, even
Adrian Brody. Yeah.
Well, whatever his name is. I don't know. You know people's.
I know a lot of actors' names better than Steve can remember them. Well, he's a big actor.
Well, once again.
But yeah, okay.
But no, I enjoy this thoroughly. It satisfies me when I get to sit down and watch this.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, I love it. And I want to thank Blair for recommending this to us. I don't know that this is something that, you know, we would have watched. I am so happy that we have and that
Definitely.
He recommended this.
Definitely.
And highly. And I love it. I enjoy it.
We wouldn't have probably watched this, at least not this soon, without Blair. So everybody give a big shout out to Blair in
the
comment
section
down below.
Well, the other thing is, you know, I wonder sometimes, you know, with the name Peaky Blinders, if that doesn't, you know, like, for some people, maybe it's the name. I don't know. I'm just saying. Maybe it's the name. But my God, is this so good? And everyone I see, I'll tell about it.
Right.
Because it's so good. It's...
I agree. It's an amazing show. This episode was amazing. I can already feel in my bones that the next episode's going to be amazing.
I'm almost...
And the next season. I mean, come on.
I'm...
Seriously.
I want to see it so bad, but I'm like, my God, if it's going to leave me on a cliffhanger, like a crazy one, or something, you know, like, because we've had that in this, where we thought something, and it was something else, and I'm not going to say anything, but wow.
Yeah.
This Peaky Blinders.
It's been an amazing journey.
Yeah.
We're not done yet, but we are catching up. After next season, after season 5, we will be caught up with all of you, and we will get to watch season 6 together.
Yeah.
And I can't wait for that.
Yeah, me either.
But with that being said,
Thank you so much for listening.
Yeah, for and
because I could
have
just
video,
went on about this.
Thank you guys so much for watching this episode with us. Please leave a like on this video. Leave your comments and questions down below. Make sure you subscribe if you're not already. Share the video and squish that bell. And we hope you guys all have an amazing and awesome day.
Hope amazing happens to you until next time. And Peaky Blinders. Peace out.